Hey, it's Pete Thorn. This is just a quick video I'm making because yesterday somebody contacted me and they let me know that Wayne Charvel, legendary founder of Charvel Guitars, has been living up in Paradise, California for a long, long time now, along with his whole extended family, with his son Michael, who also has been living there, making Paradise his home. Anyway, both Wayne and Michael have lost their homes in the devastating fire that's consumed that entire town this past week. And as well, they lost their guitar shop. I believe they owned a full-line music store up there as well. But anyway, it's just incredible to me to think about a family that's lost everything and you know, their homes as well as their place of work. And so there's been a GoFundMe started for Wayne. And I went and contributed a few bucks there today and posted it on my Facebook as well. And I thought, what else can I do? Well, I can make a YouTube video to reach some more people. I'm going to put the link to the GoFundMe down in the video description below. I don't know. This really just really shook me up. Wayne, you know, started Charvel in the early 70s. And, of course, that iconic brand associated with everybody from Eddie Van Halen and Warren Demartini, all these great guitar players. And I can still remember the Charvel guitars when they first showed up in Canada, and I went down to my local music shop that brought in five or six of them, and I remember seeing them through the glass before I even walked in the store and just being blown away because those guitars were so iconic at the time. You know, they just really had a lot to do with the whole Super Strat kind of revolution. And I actually got an 87, well, it was 86, I guess, 86 or 87 Jackson guitar that I still have to this day. It was right after they started putting Jackson on the headstock of those guitars on some of the bolt-ons, but they were still made in the U.S. In you know, they would stamp San Dimas with the neck plate that said San Dimas on it. So I still have that guitar. That guitar means a lot to me. Now, I know Wayne wasn't at the company then. I believe he sold the company in around 78 or 79 to Grover Jackson. But he started the company, and he started a revolution of super-duper cool, super Strat-style guitars that, you know, meant a lot to me as a kid growing up. And so when I heard this, I just thought, well, this is the least I can do. I'll make a little video and just post the GoFundMe link if anybody wants to go help out Wayne and his family. I think that would be an awesome thing to do. And I just had one more idea. This is just me spitballing off the top of my head and just talking. But Charvel is owned by Fender now, of course, along with Jackson. And I thought to myself, you know, what if Fender offered this guy a job and his son, because they both know about guitars and guitar building, obviously. And what if Wayne was to go to Fender and along with Michael, and they were to do a Charvel by Charvel line of guitars with maybe some of the proceeds going to the victims of the fires in Paradise, California. You know, I would buy one of those, you know. I mean, to see a Charvel that was, you know, produced with maybe, you know, senior master builder status or something afforded to Wayne, and he oversaw the production of them, I think that would be a really cool thing. I don't know if Wayne would even be interested in doing something like that, or if Fender would have any interest in doing something like that, but it would seem like a great, nice gesture. You know, all these people are in a time of need, and you know, Wayne needs help as well as all the folks of Paradise. So it was just an idea I had off the top of my head. Talk amongst yourselves. I don't know. Let me know what you think about that in the comments section. But anyway, thanks for watching this video, and best to Wayne and his family. And I hope you guys get back on your feet soon and come back stronger than ever. All right. Take care. See ya.